بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may the peace and blessings be upon his final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We'll just wait for a minute or two until the brothers go out inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Subhanallah, with Laylatul Qadr, it's very hard to know and look for the signs the next day. So the best way to do it is you go hard every night, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the reward of Laylatul Qadr. It's too hard to, this night the wind was still, and the next day you look at the sun that has no rays. Inshallah, Laylatul Qadr was last night. It's too hard. Yani people, subhanAllah, get too focused on the signs of Laylatul Qadr and miss on Laylatul Qadr. So my advice to you all, inshallah, and my wife was saying to me that before I came here, she said, I talked to many people and they say Laylatul Qadr has not yet come because there's no signs. I said to her, yani, don't worry about this. Just go hard every night and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the reward. Some people might feel the signs and see the signs, and some people might not see the signs. So, yani, getting too confused with it, I think it's just better to focus, and inshallah, we'll get it, inshallah. So, the almost four yani remaining nights of Ramadan, only four nights to go. And with that, inshallah, we need to make sure that we go hard. And I just wanted to share with you tonight the story of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because it's a beautiful story, and there's a lot of ibar and a lot of advices and a lot of things that we can take out of this story. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, now he's 63 years, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam just came back from Hajjatul Wada', which is the final pilgrimage and the only pilgrimage that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, the farewell pilgrimage, where 100,000 Muslims attended the Hajj. So subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started with one, and subhanAllah, in a matter of 23 years, yani 100,000 people came with the final pilgrimage. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, there were 120,000 Sahabi, companions. And obviously there was a lot more people around the Arabian Peninsula who already accepted Islam. So this is all started with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back, and now there's only 9 days remaining until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dies. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells his companions that he wants to visit the shuhada of Uhud, the martyrs of Uhud. It's as if that he wanted to say the final goodbye to them. So he went to Uhud, and he yani farewelled the shuhada of Uhud. And remember, in the shuhada of Uhud, Hamza ibn Abdul Muttalib, his uncle, Mus'ab ibn Umair, the first messenger that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sent to Medina to teach people of the Medina about Islam and to call them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the most beautiful sahaba as well, Anas ibn Nadr, who fought for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that battle and died and he was saying to Sa'd ibn Mu'adh on that day that I smell the smell of al-Jannah. And subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Shuhada Uhud and he said to them, أنتم السابقون ونحن إن شاء الله بكم لاحقون. That you have actually preceded us to this matter by dying beforehand. And we are inshallah going to be with you soon inshallah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this, listen to this carefully brothers and sisters. Listen to this coming sentence. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his way back, he cried. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why are you crying, O Prophet of Allah? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اشتاقت نفسي لرؤية إخواني. That my nafs, I feel very, يعني I long, I want to see my brothers. I feel like I want to see my brothers. I long for my brothers. And the Sahaba, the companion said, aren't we your brothers, O Prophet of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you are my companions, but my brothers are people who come after me and didn't see me and yet believe in me and follow me. Referring to who? To us. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is longing to see us, wanting to see us. And yet subhanallah we يعني, deviate from his path. See, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried when he remembered us. اشتاقت نفسي لرؤية إخواني. He wants to see us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to sit with us and tell us about his stories and tell us about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam referring to us as his brothers. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 9 days as I said before his death, the last verse of the Quran was revealed, which is وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. This was the last verse revealed in the Quran. And then days has passed by and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has felt that the severity of the illness subhanAllah is increasing. He started to feel ill and started to feel a lot of pain and a lot of fever subhanAllah. And it's only 3 or 4 days remaining to his death. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that time, he was, it's the night of Maymuna, his wife Maymuna. He was supposed to be spending the night with Maymuna. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that night, he subhanAllah felt very, very ill. So he said to Maymuna and he said to his wife, can you please allow me to inshallah be to spend the last يعني, few nights of this particular night to inshallah يعني, with my sickness in the house of Aisha radiallahu anha, with Aisha radiallahu anha. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is actually taking permission of Maymuna and taking permission of his wives to actually go to spend the night with Aisha. يعني, how great is the Prophet of Allah? يعني, he could have just said, take me to Aisha. No. But because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understand that you have to be just, subhanAllah, he asked their permission. And they said, of course, O Prophet of Allah. And Ali ibn Abi Talib and Al-Fadl ibn Abi Al-Abbas, two of the companions, carried the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually carried him, because he couldn't walk. And as they were carrying him from the room of Maymuna to the room of Aisha, because you know that the rooms of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ were just pretty much next to the mosque, or was part of the mosque. So the companions saw Al-Fadl ibn Abi Al-Abbas and Ali ibn Abi Talib carrying the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So subhanAllah, they got really worried. And the people yani, started to feel that this is actually serious. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is really unwell. And people started to, subhanAllah, mumbling in the mosque and started to sort of really يعني, be very upset. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard them. And he is now with Aisha radiallahu anha. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take me to them. But before you take me to them, because I have high fever, make sure you pour water on me. So subhanAllah, they poured 7 sort of water bottles, big water bottles on him so that his temperature would go down. Very, very high temperature. So they took him to the Sahaba. They took him to the mosque. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam stood on the minbar for the very last time. For the very last time, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is standing on the pulpit. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Assalamu alaykum, my companions." And he said a speech, so we'll take just bits of this speech. He said, إِنَّ عَبْدًا خَيَّرَهُ اللَّهُ بَيْنَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ فَاخْتَارَ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أو كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. That a slave, a servant, has been given the choice between this dunya and what's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hereafter, al-akhira. So he chose al-akhira. So everyone was listening to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and Abu Bakr heard that and started weeping because he understood that he's referring to himself, the Prophet of Allah. He was given the choice to be the king of kings in this dunya or to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he chose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he stood up, Abu Bakr, and said, فِدَيْنَاكَ بِأَبِينَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ فَدَيْنَاكَ بِأُمَّهَاتِنَا بِزَوْجَاتِنَا بِأَوْلَادِنَا. O Prophet of Allah, we sacrifice for your sake our wives, our children, our fathers and mothers. And the people in the mosque said, yani looked at Abu Bakr, how can you interrupt the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to them, leave Abu Bakr alone. Every one of you has made us a favor and we return the favor to him except Abu Bakr. We leave the returning of the favor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, who accompanied the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was the first one to believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the men, who accompanied the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his journey from the beginning, who believed in him, supported him. The iman of Abu Bakr, if you put the iman of Abu Bakr in one bit part of the scales and put the iman of the whole ummah in one scale, the iman of Abu Bakr will exceed, will be heavier. So he said that everyone we are able to reward except Abu Bakr. We're not able to reward. So we leave the reward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the doors to the mosque should be shut except the door of Abu Bakr. Referring to the Abu Bakr is a sign that Abu Bakr is the one to succeed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said in the same khutbah, Allah, Allah fi salah. Allah, Allah fi salah, meaning that the salah is very important, have very high status. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is advising the Muslims to hold on tight to the salah. So this is a message for the people who don't care about the salah. This is the last khutbah, the last advice the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave to the Muslims, as-salah, praying, the prayers, that the Muslim subhanallah would leave. That a Muslim subhanallah would say, sorry, I'm working and it's too hard. Inshallah, I'll pray the dhuhr and the asr and the maghrib and the isha, inshallah, when I get home. And not only that, subhanallah, they sleep and don't pray the fajr at all. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, اتقوا الله في النساء وصيكم بالنساء خيرا. The last thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, that we should take care of women. This is the last words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam, dear brothers and sisters, elevates women to a very high status. By one thing, by even ordering the women to be in hijab, Islam elevates the status of the women. Because women in Islam are like jewels. Would you leave your jewel out of the safe? Of course not. And in Islam, the women is like jewels and gold and subhanallah and diamonds. So they have to be covered. They have to be locked from all the bad things, and they have to be covered in hijab. So this is a message for the husbands who prevent their wives from wearing hijab. This is also a message for the wives who wear the hijab, for the women who wear the hijab part time. Islam elevates you, dear sister. Wear the hijab. The hijab is the sign of iman. The hijab is the sign of taqwa. So this is the last words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes dua to the Muslim ummah and says, أيدكم الله حفظكم الله ثبتكم الله أيدكم الله. So he makes dua to the ummah to remain on the straight path, to be guided to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says a last statement and says, deliver my salam to the people who come after me until the day of judgment. Wa alayka as-salam, O Prophet of Allah. And you remember us, O Prophet of Allah. We are your brothers. And subhanAllah, you remember us with salam. These are your last words, O Prophet of Allah. So the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes back to Aisha. And subhanAllah, he's now very, very weak. He's getting so weak. He's not even able to join the Muslims in the prayer in the mosque. So Abu Bakr, he orders Abu Bakr to lead the prayer. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not for the very first time, not able to lead the Muslims for 17 prayers in a row. And Yawm al-Ithnain, Monday, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the day when he is about to die. Remember, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on a Monday and dies on a Monday. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Salatul Fajr, he finds himself that he's able to move. So he opens the curtain and he sees the Muslims praying Salatul Fajr behind Abu Bakr. So he removes the curtain, and then the Muslims, while they're praying, they see the Prophet of Allah. And subhanAllah, they're so wanting to even, يعني, almost they're going to leave the Salah and look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam face. The face that's full of light. The face that is full of mahabba. The face that is full of love to us. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does a signal with his hands that stay as you are. And then closes the curtain again. And this was the very last time that the Sahaba saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alive. And now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is between the hands of Aisha radiallahu anha. And Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr, one of the companions, walks into the room. And he has a siwak in his mouth. So the Prophet ﷺ looks at the siwak. But he's so weak that he can't say, I want that siwak. The Prophet ﷺ wants to do the sunnah of siwak even when he's dying, yes. And subhanAllah, a lot of Muslims these days, they don't want anything to do with siwak. They don't want anything to do with siwak. They say, I'm very embarrassed that I walk and, you know, have a piece of tree in my mouth. This is the sunnah of your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Aisha radiallahu anha understands that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to use the siwak. So she says to Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr, her brother, to give her the siwak. So she takes the siwak from Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr and she puts it in her mouth, so to make it softer. And she puts the siwak in the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted that the last يعني saliva of in the Prophet ﷺ mouth to be from Aisha radiallahu anha, his wife. So where did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where is the Prophet ﷺ now? He is between the neck and the chest of Aisha radiallahu anha. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't die in a battle, doesn't die when he's reading the Quran, doesn't die when he is praying. He dies in the arms, between the arms of his wife. Again, a message to the status of the women in Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha is holding him and he looks up and says, بَلِ الرَّفِيقِ الْأَعْلَى. No, I choose to be with the highest of the companions, referring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Aisha understands from this that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking to Jibreel. And Jibreel is telling him to choose again between to stay in this dunya or to go and to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he chooses to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dies. And Aisha doesn't know what to do. It's the very first time that they have this moment that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead. And she doesn't know what to do. So she opens the curtain and she says, Mata Rasulullah! Mata Rasulullah! Mata Rasulullah! The Prophet is dead! The Prophet is dead! The Prophet is dead! And the people in the mosque are shocked. Ali ibn Abi Talib falls on the ground from the shock and the surprise. Uthman ibn Affan is like a kid. They take him to anywhere and he doesn't know where to go. And Umar ibn al-Khattab takes his sword and he says, if anyone says that Muhammad is dead, I will cut his head. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu walks to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He looks at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for the very last time. And he says, Wa khalilah, wa habibah, wa safiyah, wa nabiyah, tibtu hayyan ya Rasulallah, wa tibtu mayyitan ya Rasulallah. He goes inside and says about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Oh my friend, Oh my dearest of all, Oh my Prophet, you were pure when you are alive, and you are pure when you're dead. And he goes, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq goes back into the mosque, and he finds Umar ibn al-Khattab threatening people with his sword. And he says to him, Umar, ijlis, sit down. And Umar ibn al-Khattab doesn't listen. So then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq goes on the pulpit, on the minbar, and says his very famous words, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ مَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ مُحَمَّدًا فَإِنَّ مُحَمَّدًا قَدْ مَاتْ وَمَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيٌّ لَا يَمُوتْ O people, whoever used to worship Muhammad, Muhammad is dead. And who is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is alive and will never die. And Umar ibn al-Khattab at that time realized that that's it. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead. Imagine, dear brothers and sisters, the musibah, the calamity that came upon the Muslims on that day. 23 years listening to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, living with him, sharing with him the moments of joy and sadness, learning from him, listening the Quran from him, listening the hadith, instructing the sahaba, being the leader in jihad, being the leader of the army, sending messages to the kings around the world, following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, being the followers of the greatest religion of all time. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is no longer available. He's no longer there with them. And they take the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and bury him. And Fatima, the daughter of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says to Ali ibn Abi Talib and the Sahaba, do you actually, your heart permit you to put sand and dirt on the Prophet, on top of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And Bilal ibn Rabah, the muadhin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, goes to make, so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died at sunrise. And remember, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born at the time of sunrise and also dies at the time of the sunrise. He brought light to this world, and he also brought light to this world when he died by bringing his sunnah, by leaving his sunnah. Anas ibn Malik said that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, everything was turned to light. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, everything went back into darkness. The Sahaba was so sad. The passing by would hear the Sahaba, the companions, brothers and sisters crying inside the houses. And Bilal ibn Rabah now stands to make the adhan of Salatul Dhuhr, the very first adhan that he makes without the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being alive. And he says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan. And he can't complete. He cannot finish the adhan. He can't say ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead. He can't continue. He can't say the adhan anymore because his habib, his safi, his khalil has died, has passed away, O Prophet of Allah. And Abu and Bilal ibn Rabah struggled over the next day to give the adhan and he couldn't. And at the end he said to Abu Bakr, please relieve me from the mission of giving the adhan. I can't do it anymore. This is the story of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The biggest calamity to happen to us, the biggest calamity to happen to the Muslim ummah is the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the biggest calamity. So if anyone gets any calamity of his in his life, remember the calamity of losing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Your calamity will be so small compared to that. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam didn't leave us alone. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left his sunnah. The only person in the world whose sayings, actions, every single thing he did and said, even when entering the bathroom, documented in the kutub of hadith, in the books of hadith. He left his sunnah with us so that we can learn from it, walk on the path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and learn and learn and be like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his companions. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam didn't leave us alone. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather us inshallah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and with the companions on the day of judgment. And we'll meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and we'll say, O Prophet of Allah, we are your brothers. Here we are, we come to see you, O Prophet of Allah. Please give us a sip of drink from your hawd, from Al-Kawthar. And after that, inshallah, we would never go thirsty. And lead us to Jannah, O Prophet of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshaAllah gather us with him and the companions of the day of judgment. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with him and the companions inshaAllah in Jannah. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه سبحانك الله وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت واستغفرك وأتوب إليك. جزاكم الله خير.